something that nobody knows. That her eyes are as big as a bubbling tub. Feet of the queen of the hearts of the cards. Her feet are all covered with towels and scars. I remember when you and me, how we used to be such good friends, couldn't give me none. What a song! This is Jack Johnson, and this one's called Bubbly Toes, or Bubble Toes. And it's a great song. I'm gonna teach it to you today. Isn't that great? Alright, so there's a few parts of this song. Basically, it has the same kind of chords patterns the whole way through, which is basically G, C, and going up to D. Now, there is this little bit at the beginning as well. It's gonna require you stretching your hands to an unimaginable width. Oh my god. Yeah, but it's still pretty good. It sounds amazing. It's got that really nice blues kind of. So that's really good. I'm going to teach that for you as well. And there's a little bit at the beginning, which is like that. And it's not too hard. Don't worry about it. If you're freaking out right now, don't worry about it. Alright, so the first bit I'm going to start teaching to you is basically kind of like bar chords, but not really. It's not even really like power chords, because you only use two fingers, your index and this one. So those are the only two that you're going to need for the beginning here. And how it's going to work is you're basically going to put your index finger on the fifth fret of the fifth string over here. And you're going to put your ring finger on the seventh fret of the fourth string. Like so. And you're just going to tap both of those at the same time, one downward, like this. And what you're going to do there is just take exactly the same formation, just move it up one string. Up. Like that. See? So. And instead of this one, you're just going to move it up here, so your index is going to be on the 5th fret of the 6th string, and your ring finger is just going to be on the 7th fret of the 5th string. Right, like that. So, pretty simple, just move it up, and then take exactly the same one once again. This time, move it up the fretboard 2 frets, but just have the exact same one. So, basically, now your index is going to be on the 7th fret over here, and your ring finger is just going to be on the 9th fret of the 4th string, like this. And after that, the next one in line is basically really simply just put those two formation fingers up one on the string and just one fret down the fretboard. So essentially, you're going to have your ring finger on the 10th fret of the 5th string, and your index finger on the it's going to be the 8th fret of the 6th string, like that. Okay, so now you've got to kind of know these different little chords, not really, just little half chords kind of. What is pretty important now is knowing how to change between them. So it goes quite fast. It goes, it's as simple as something that nobody knows. See that? So you basically have to just strum once, and then really quickly, so it's down,